Former India cricketer Chetan Chauhan passed away after a multiple organ failure on Sunday. Chauhan, who was a BJP minister in Uttar Pradesh government, was admitted to a private hospital in Lucknow almost a month back after contracting COVID-19. His condition worsened recently and was on ventilator for the past few days. Chauhan played 40 tests and 7 ODIs for India and also served as the president of the Delhi and District Cricket Association. Continuing the downward trend, India's COVID-19 case fatality rate on Sunday dropped to 1.93%, which is one of the lowest globally. The Health Ministry said this is a result of coordinated efforts of the centre and state and union territory governments. The USA crossed 50,000 deaths in 23 days, Brazil in 95 days, and Mexico in 141 days. India took 156 days to reach this national figure. The ministry said as the number of fatalities due to coronavirus infection in the country reached 49,980. With monsoon session of parliament set to be held on a fully physical model, multiple reports say the two houses will take turns to work, either as morning and evening shifts or by working on alternate days. The Indian Express wrote, quoting sources, that 168 lower house members will be seated in Lok Sabha chamber and the others distributed across the lower house galleries and the Rajya Sabha and its galleries. Similarly, the 241 members of the Rajya Sabha will be spread across the chambers of the upper and lower houses. Large display screens, audio consoles in the galleries, ultraviolet germicidal radiation, special cables connecting the two houses for transmission of audiovisual signal inside the chamber and in the galleries are being installed to carry out the proceedings smoothly, the newspaper wrote. There will also be a specific allocation of seats for the members of both ruling and opposition parties.
After the Wall Street Journal reported that Facebook opposed applying its hate speech rules to entities linked with the BJP, Congress leader Rahul Gandhi on Sunday said that the ruling party controls the social networking sites and uses them to spread fake news in order to influence voters. In a tweet, the former Congress president wrote BJP and RSS control Facebook and WhatsApp in India, and finally, American media has come out with the truth about Facebook. The Wall Street Journal reported that citing business imperatives, Facebook's top public policy executive in India opposed applying hate speech rules to at least 4 individuals and groups linked with the BJP, despite the fact that they were flagged internally for promoting or participating in violence. The report claimed that Facebook India's public policy director told staff members that punishing violations by BJP politicians would damage the company's business prospects in the country. India is Facebook's biggest global market by number of users.
A document released by the Indian Railways notes that private operators who will be handed over 150 trains to ply on 109 routes will have the freedom to choose halt stations of the trains they operate. However, the private operators have to submit in advance to the railways the list of such intermediate stations on the train's paths where they are proposing halts. According to the draft of the concession agreement, the private operators also have to provide the time in and time out at the intermediate railway stations, which shall form part of the train operation plan. This has to be submitted in advance and will be in place for at least a year, after which it can be revised. Many areas in Hyderabad are inundated as incessant rains since past 3 days continue to wreak havoc. With the weatherman predicting more rains for the coming 3 days, the K. Chandrasekhar Rao government has issued high alert in many areas. The National Disaster Response Force teams have been deployed for rescue and relief operations at several places. The Telangana government has kept 2 helicopters ready for rescuing those stranded in the floods, and 1 chopper from the military has also been kept ready for use. 2 people have been arrested in connection with the death of a 20-year-old student in Bulandshahar, police said on Sunday. Sudeeksha Bhatti, who hailed from Deris Kanar village in Gautam Buddha Nagar's Dadri, died on August 10th in a road crash in Bulandshahar district while she was pillion riding a motorcycle with her cousin. Police said they arrested the 2 people, Deepak Chaudhary and Raju, on the basis of CCTV footage. They have also seized the bike they were riding at the time of the accident. Sudeeksha was pursuing a graduation course in entrepreneurship at Babson College, Massachusetts, and was scheduled to go back on August 20th. While her family has alleged that the two men were harassing her, the police have said it was an accident.
Actor Ranveer Singh has penned a heartfelt post after Mahendra Singh Dhoni announced retirement from international cricket. Sharing throwback pictures with MS Dhoni, Ranveer recalled how he took up a job as an assistant director in 2007-2008 just to see the cricketer. The Gully Boy actor said like a true fanboy, he hung out with Dhoni and got his cap and jersey signed after the release of his band Baja Bharat. Ranveer ended the emotional post thanking Mahi for bringing glory to the nation and filling a billion hearts with pride.